Today's ride was done on November 17th, 2024, from my house in Hudson Falls to Lake St. Catherine in Wells, Vermont, across the border from Granville, New York, and back home for 53.9 miles, and here's part one.
Thank you. Thank you.
Before you go, I've got some great news for you. The best news in human history. Eternal life is a free gift. Let me share some Bible verses with you. Let's start with 1 John chapter 5, verses 11 through 15. And this is the record that God has given to us, eternal life. Notice we can't earn it. And this life is in His Son, Jesus. He that receives the Son, Jesus, as his personal Savior, has eternal life. He who rejects the Son has eternal death. These things have been written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that you may know that you have eternal life. Let's go over some prerequisites in the book of Romans, chapter 3, verse 23. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. None of us is perfect like God. We all fall short of the perfection. We all sin. Romans 6:23 says, for the wages of sin is death. That's eternal death. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Notice the wages of sin is death, meaning we can earn eternal death. We can't earn eternal life. We can only accept it as a gift. And the second part of the verse says, the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Romans 10:13, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved, saved from eternal death. So, whosoever shall call upon his name shall be saved. I have called on his name many, many years ago. My life has been changed. I've been following him ever since. And I'm assured that I have eternal life because the Bible tells me so. And I invite you today to accept Jesus as your personal Savior. Accept the free gift of eternal life provided by his death on the cross, and know for sure that you have eternal life. God bless you. We'll see you next time.